Hey everyone, welcome back to another Exos Heroes video. So today's video, we're discussing the overall tier list for October 2021. But before that, if you want an updated Exos Heroes videos, please hit the subscribe button down below. Okay guys, so just to remind you that this tier list is actually available in the description below. This is a sequence of tier lists since August. Then this one is from September. Just want to review it for the changes. We have Dorka, Tantalo, FC Jin, FC Carry. These were the movers from last month. Seowa, FC Chatty, FC Baraka. Then you have FC Kailak, FC Rhinor, and FC Mahar. The rest didn't move from August to September. Let's take a look at the tier list for October. So as you can see, for Tier E still needs a lot of work. No movement from the bottom. Still the same. Let's proceed to your Tier D. Tier D, there were a couple of movements going up, but here are the ones that are here and really needs work also. Okay, except for Janai, because Janai is going to be the base or the original hero for Janai. And her FC is actually way up there. Okay, Epritheof is also here for a general. And the rest are actually Fatecores. So the excitement is in, is in Tier C, which is viable. So for Tier C, there are two new additions since September. Okay. First, I'll mention FC Reed Marie, which is here, which is FC RM. It's actually a very long name. That is why I put it RM. FC Reed Marie's rework was kind of enough to propel her to at least go up, go up a tier. Not much in terms of being a very impactful rework, but kind of decent enough that she went from tier D to tier C. Then for FC Nero, new Fatecores, by the way, I think the last one to be released for October. FC Nero's kit, although I like the turn resets, the buffs for attack, but eventually those are his passives. But His skills, S1 and S2, are not really... It's not really that impactful that it deserves to be a tier up. I'm sure they're going to rework him in the future. He needs his skills to be reworked, but his passive is already okay. He needs to be reworked again for his S1 and S2. Okay, so for Tier B, no changes except for the new ones that... One is a rework, which is FC Deva. FC Deva was actually previously in Tier C. Now she's in Tier B. She gives you more of anti-health regeneration and additional attacks if she attacked that specific hero. So if that hero's HP actually drops to 50% or less. So again, it gives her additional attacks. She is still viable, I think, in tag. She's going to be good in tag now with additions to her kit. But for your main PvP team, I don't think she'll be, she'll be there yet. Zarin, good kit as well. I think in terms of protection, she is going to, she needs a little bit more. I'm actually okay with her being at B, but I'm still skeptical on what she can do really in PvP in terms of really real-time protection in terms of her kit. She is against those who have death immunity, I think. So Zarin needs to be playtested, needs to be in PvP for her to shine. For FC Valar, the male version, I'm actually intrigued with this one because I used to bring the girl version FC Valar in my team. And his S2 is actually good. Enough for him to go up from Tier C. He's actually in Tier B already when he came in. So again, FC Valar is going to be... His S2 is quite intriguing because of... I think he has silence in his S2. He has I think anti-heal buff, debuffs as well in his S2, which makes it more interesting. The problem is I don't have his FC. That is why I can't really play test him now. But if I do get him in the future, I will really showcase him and on how his S2 really, really works. Okay, next is going to be your tier A. Don't have any changes in tier A. So most of the heroes that I had previously, tier A actually went up. So for tier S, we have here somebody who went up. Sewa actually from tier A went up to tier S. Very, very good right now in PvP in terms of complement. If she wants to compliment, or if she is complimenting Schmidt. And we have our first new addition to S, which is John Donk. His kit is a mix of survivability, protection, the buffs, attack buffs. And when I saw his kit, he is actually viable in Linombe. So come to think of it, he is going to be good there. So John Donk is a gold Fatecore, which is here in tier S, and he has a lot of potential, especially in PvP. It would really depend on how you build around a team for him or on how he is going to complement other heroes. So it would really boil down the next couple of weeks on how players are going to play him. Are they going to play more in PvP? But definitely a good all-around hero to have for PvP and for PvE. Next is our SS tier, which is our last tier. So we have here finally Rhynor and Kari. Okay, these two really are wreaking havoc in PvP. FC Kari more or less has replaced FC Ramji. FC Ramji is still in A, while FC Kari is in SS already. Rhynor, once she gets her Fatecore, is going to be a beast. At this point, she has, in terms of power level, she has kind of Dorka-esque power level. So that is why, in terms of the counters that she has, in terms of basic hits, I've seen Rhynor dominate with critical hits just for basic hits. So again, she's going to be a headache moving forward. For those who have built their Rhynor, congratulations, because she is going to be dominant in the future. I tell you, dominant in the future. Okay, guys, so this is just the new additions for the tier list. I don't want to discuss the whole tier list because it's usually the same discussions for the old heroes that I have. But for the new ones, I've added them here. Some I've ranked up because of changes to the kit. But for the in the general tier list, it is still the same for October. And again, for those who want to see the tier list, you may check this out in the description. I'll put a link there so that you may, you know, take a look at this tier list and see for yourself who you want to focus on, who you want to develop, and who you want to rely on for your team. Okay, guys, so thank you very much for staying this far in this video. Please do subscribe and support my channel because this helps my channel a lot. Also, don't forget to click that bell icon and put a like to this video. Thank you, guys. Stay safe. Take care. This is the Warden, and I'm out of here.